Welcome to the Bucket Plan On Demand, a podcast for financial advisors based on the best-selling book and process that simplifies financial planning. Hear from skilled industry professionals and special guests each episode that will help perfect your approach with clients and your results.
Hello, I'm Bryan Bibbo. I was a guest on the episode you're about to hear. A little while ago, myself, Jason, and Dave got together for the Holistic Wealth and Health podcast by J.L. Smith. We were discussing the different steps of the holistic wealth management process. We found the information to be incredibly valuable and decided to bring it over to the Bucket Plan On Demand podcast. We hope you enjoy as we begin our discussion on the first step, Discover.
I am your host, Jason Smith, and I'm here with my co-host, Bryan Bibbo. And today we have a series of episodes that we're going to be releasing for you. This is kind of part one, where we're going to go through the actual bucket plan holistic wealth management process in a little bit more detail to kind of give you a good understanding of what the experience will be like, or even remind you for current clients of what the experience was like when you came through this discovery process. We're going to talk about the questions that we ask, the tools and concepts that we cover, and really just give you a play-by-play of exactly what it looks like to go through the discovery step of the holistic wealth management process, the bucket plan. So, Bryan, we have a special guest today that we've had before, Dave Allison. And Dave is my partner at Prosperity Capital Advisors. He's also the president of that organization. He heads up the investment committee. Bryan and Dave co-train this bucket plan holistic wealth management process to other financial advisors all over the country throughout the year. They do that together. And so Dave is an amazing resource for us because at J.L. Smith, Prosperity Capital Advisors is an extension of us. It's like our back office. When you're a financial advisor, when you're a fiduciary, you are under the governing body of the SEC, and you have to have a registered investment advisory firm, which is what Prosperity Capital Advisors is, that basically handles compliance supervision. They also do all our trading and reporting, and they do our portfolio management. They do quite a bit in the back office to help J.L. Smith stay focused on serving clients. And so, Dave, welcome, and thanks for joining us today.
Yeah, thanks for having me. Looking forward to today's episode.
All right, let's get into it. This is going to be a lot of fun. We've not done anything like this before, so this is going to be kind of our first time doing this. Now, when I say we've not done this before, we've not sat down, the three of us, and had a dialogue where we walked through what somebody would experience as they go through discovery, right? As they go through the full holistic wealth management process. Of course, we'll be recording the other design, delivery, and then dedicated. But this is going to be really neat, I think, because the current clients are going to have flashbacks, right, of the experience they went through and the value that they received by going through the process. And I think then other listeners who are not yet clients are going to have a really good insight into exactly what's going to happen when they come in for their discovery meeting.
Yeah. So, you know, I have a buddy who always kind of gives a quote. He says, personal finance is more personal than it is finance. And so I think that the core of discovery is that, you know, there's so many different ways that we help clients, whether it's financial planning. And even in the realm of financial planning, it could be income planning for somebody getting ready to retire. It could be goals-based planning for a younger client. We do asset management. We do tax management. We do protection planning, legacy planning, all these different disciplines as part of a holistic process. And so for me, the value of discovery is learning all about what's most important to the client right now so that we can tailor a specific plan, ideas, and recommendations that align with the challenges, the concerns, the priorities, and the things that are on the minds of our clients.
Yeah, and I think you put yourself in the client's shoes and you're walking in to see a financial advisor, and maybe it's the first time they've seen a financial advisor, or maybe they previously had one along the way, but there has to be a little of that thought, and I hear this a lot. It's like, did I save enough? Did I accumulate? Because what are you doing? You're going in there, and maybe you're 50, 60 years of age, and you're bringing in everything you've done in your life, right? You're showing an individual everything you've accomplished in your life. And Dave, I think you said it best, is like with finance, it's not really talked about. Do you talk to your neighbor about your finances? No. Right. It's in America, it's just a little bit of a kind of feng shui thing where it's not too talked about. So as those clients walk into the office, it's kind of a little unsettling. And what we're really trying to do in this first phase of the holistic process, the discovery phase, is understand what's in people's minds, what's in their hearts. What are their goals? What do they want to accomplish? I mean, I think that's the most important thing. And it's us getting to know them. They might have seen us before, whether it be on another podcast like this one, or we've done an in-person workshop, or they've seen us virtually, or maybe they were even referred to us from friends, but it's still that little bit of angst there too. And we're meeting them for the first time, right? So it's like, where's the common ground here? Where's the common ground? How can I get to know these people a little bit better? Because at the end of the day, everyone's situation is different, right? Your situation is different than mine. Dave's different than ours. So at the end of the day, it's like, how can we provide value? And as a financial fiduciary, we just want to make sure is what is in their minds, what's in their heart, and how can we address that and really provide that value?
Yeah. What's funny is you said that, Bryan. I had a flashback. You know how I was saying, like, current clients will have a flashback of, like, the experience they had? So I've mentioned this before, I'm a client of the firm. And so through the years, I mean, I had my own bucket plan and, of course, family estate organizer, and I had a written financial plan and all those things, you know, put in place on my own. But then I decided, as Bryan, a number of years ago, to actually go through the process with Holly and I, my wife. And I remember, like, is the weirdest thing, right? I'm the owner of the firm, but like our co-owner, but ultimately, like, I was a little bit almost nervous going into discovery. Like, it was like, this is weird. Like, why am I feeling a little nervous to go into this meeting? So I think you hit the nail on the head of the feelings that can happen.
I think one of the weirdest things out there is like telling a stranger how much money you make, how much money you've accumulated. Like, to Bryan's point, that is kind of taboo in America to talk about, but the reality of it is this is what we do day in and day out to help people make the right decisions. And so it is, and Bryan, you're dead on with that point.
I mean, it takes a lot of strength too to go in there and be vulnerable of like mistakes you've made. And I think that's probably why I was a little nervous going in there with Holly, because I was like the shoemaker's kid. I had cobbled together, you know what I mean? But my shoes were not like perfectly shined, right? And so I had components of a really strong holistic plan in place, but I knew there was gaps, and that's why I wanted to go through the process and actually be treated exactly like a client of the firm many years ago. So I think there was a little bit of like that vulnerability that I had to be willing to go in there and admit, like, these are things I don't really have in place that I should already.
Don't feel too bad. I mean, how many times have you gone to a doctor and looked at that doctor and been like, ooh, you're in bad health? So, you know, don't feel too bad as a financial advisor not having your total financial house in order. At least you were wise enough to realize that you turned it over to the firm now to have accountability in your own plan and really kind of have somebody proactively doing it full time for you.
Yeah, no, and I think it's a culture thing too. It's like, there's always that mentality of like keeping up with the Joneses, and you see someone else from the outside and his perception, and you're making a judgment, and then you go see this individual. Did I do enough? Did I save enough? What mistakes did I make along the way? At the end of the day, why? Why are you even going to that financial advisor in the first place? Because there's a whole gamut of benefits that we can provide. This is what we do on a day-to-day basis, right? So when you think about this, is maybe you've saved greatly along the way, but how do I get the money at most out tax efficiently? There's so many different things that as an individual, if this isn't your expertise, how much more value that there is working with another individual or a firm that can provide that type of value. So I'm just trying to talk people over that hurdle of like, ooh, I think we got everyone's like blood pressure up talking about walking into our offices. And now I'm trying to calm it down a little bit, saying that there's a purpose for this, there's a why, and there's a whole amount of value that we can provide.
The why piece is so important though, Bryan, because like, again, now I'm just in this mode thinking about the experience Holly and I had. There were two major whys that I had. Number one, I knew there were I's that weren't dotted, T's that weren't crossed, and I wanted to shore it up, right? I had a desire to do that. Number two, though, is Holly was not in the know as much as she should have been, right? Yeah. I had said, like, God forbid if something unexpected happened to me. And Holly would like, obviously we have you guys and we have a firm, we have all these resources, but even me, I was a little nervous. Like, she's going to be a little in the dark though. She is not as well informed as she really needs to be able to step in and make good decisions. Cause at the end of the day, they are her decisions. Yes, she's going to trust you and Dave and Chad and others that she'll rely on, but she needs to know what's going on.
Well, and Jason, I just want to share, like, that's such an important topic because oftentimes when a client books this Discover meeting with me, they might have one of the two spouses that's the primary financial decision maker, and maybe that spouse wants to come into the meeting by themselves. And we don't mandate that our clients do anything. At the end of the day, it's their life, it's their money, it's their decisions. But we highly, highly encourage both spouses to be present in this Discover meeting because it helps get the two of them on the same page as to what their goals are, what their objectives are, what they have, where they might have gaps in their existing plan. And it brings a lot of proactive education to maybe that non-financially savvy spouse. And so this is just such a powerful meeting to bring everybody together in one room to openly share goals, objectives, dreams, values. Because at the end of the day, the money is just a means to achieve the goals and desires and fulfillments that we have in life. And so to your point on you and Holly participating together, we see that over and over with clients that they're just so thankful that both spouses were involved in this Discover meeting, even if only one of them is kind of the primary financial controller, if you will, of the household.
And even as like a single individual or maybe a widowed individual, there's a huge purpose here too. It's like Father Time, unfortunately, is undefeated for all of us, and it's making sure that everything's in order, right? And everyone has a purpose here. So whether we're working with a married couple, a single individual, or someone that's widowed, I mean, the whole purpose of this is just to get out on the table what you have and make sure you're organized for the future generations. Maybe it's your surviving spouse and the married couple, but it could also be, hey, your children, your beneficiaries, getting a game plan in place for all of that.
And a confidence in yourself that you're not going to run out of money, right?
Yeah.
Like, what blows me away is, like, no matter how much income and money almost anybody, I'm sure billionaires are in a different group, but, you know, the more you make, the more you tend to spend, you create a lifestyle for yourself, and then you worry about, like, is there a possibility I could run out of money? Like, I need a written plan. I need to know that I can confidently enjoy the resources that I've accumulated and not run the risk at the end of being broke or out of money. All right, so let's dive into the meat of this. And the first kind of thing that we do, right, when we sit down with a new potential relationship as we're meeting them for the first time, is we want to make sure that we feel like that person, and I think you know within 5 minutes, that you could know, like, and trust that person, right? Like, that you actually want to have a relationship, or you could see yourself having a relationship with that person. And I think that's both sides, right? Like, the advisor has to have a desire to have a relationship with those people or that person sitting across from them. And then it's the same way on the other side. those people need to want to have or could see themselves having a relationship with that advisor. And that's the first and most important thing. Like, if you're not going to make that connection, or you feel like there's just a not an alignment, you're just better off to really cordially end the meeting sooner rather than later, because you're just wasting your own time spending the time in there just being cordial for an hour or so, and really maybe after 5, 10, 15 minutes.
And Dave, I'll kind of speak for the both of us here, as we see a lot of clients in both our firms, is when we talk to those individuals and try to find a common ground, I care about, Dave cares about, where they're going to be 10, 20, 30 years from now. So when they walk in there, it's not just about the money that they've accumulated and everything else. It's like, if we're going to go down this path and create this long-term relationship, I want to make sure your family is taken care of. You're taken care of in the best and the worst case scenarios. Like, I have a vested well-being in those individuals that are coming in. It's just not a financial transaction. It's also the future. I'm going to see you multiple times throughout the year. I'm going to bump into you at different events. And maybe we've had a dinner event where you came to. It's like, I care about the long run. Like, we have a vested interest in, you know, what you're passionate about and how the future is going to turn out. Because at the end of the day, it's not just about the dollars, as I keep saying, but it's about your future, that you're healthy, you're taken care of, and you don't run out of money. Like, that really matters to us. And it's also that personal connection that we're making, because I want to run into you in the grocery store, say hi, talk to you for 5 or 10 minutes. I have my children with me, and we can catch up on those things, because beyond finance, there's a whole nother part of life.
Yeah, I think, Bryan, you hit the nail on the head. And I've heard you say this over and over, but, you know, I know at least at both of our firms, we don't try to be all things to all people. It's all about the right fit. And for me, it's kind of the friend test. When I'm in a discovery meeting with a potential new client, like, if I don't see them as somebody that I would want to be friends with or hang out with kind of outside of our financial meetings, maybe it's not a good fit. And the reason that I say that is, like, they might not be totally comfortable, to Jason, your point, and have the trust in me in reciprocal. And if they're not open and have complete trust and faith in working with us or engaging with us, we're not going to be able to help them and maximize the value that we could provide to them. It's like, if you go to the doctor and you only tell the doctor a couple of the symptoms, they can't properly diagnose you. And we're the same way. Like, I love when we have really meaningful engagements with our clients where they tell us everything, because whether we can fix it or provide a solution or a recommendation or not, at least we're just another friendly ear to listen and be able to be a sounding board and give them some perspective. And so I think, you know, as if anybody's listening to this that hasn't actually hired one of our firms yet, I think that's the most important thing for you to evaluate in the Discover meeting too, is if you're meeting with Bryan, if you're meeting with me, if you're meeting with any of the advisors on the teams of the firms that you're working with, like, put that own kind of litmus test to the table.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think the last thing I wanted to say on this before we kind of move on to talking about what we do in a meeting, after we kind of make sure there's a mutual connection, right, that you could see yourself in a relationship, then we kind of move on to talking about what the agenda of the meeting looks like and, you know, kind of what's going to happen throughout the rest of the time together. But, you know, I think regardless, if Bryan, you gave a great example and you probably recently ran into a client at the grocery store and you're playing that in your head, right?
Yeah.
But I think regardless if it's in person or the relationship is via Zoom, which a lot of people are preferring these days just for efficiency, to not have to do the drive. And so much of the world has just gone this way of operating via Zoom or via phone and over camera, over meetings, regardless of which way, going back to, like, you just need to see yourself, know that you're going to enjoy the time you spend with that person. That's the first most important thing in that first 5 to 15 minutes, is make sure that this is somebody that when you do get back on a Zoom or get in person or run into them in a grocery store, you're going to enjoy seeing and expending time in talking to that person. All right, let's talk about the agenda next. So, Dave, tell me about, like, as somebody comes in and sits down, and you've done that first part that we just talked about, and now you're going into kind of the rest of the, getting into the meat of the meeting, right? The first thing that we do is we talk about kind of setting up the agenda, right? Making sure that we cover the things that are most important to them and making sure that we follow our process to kind of dot the I's, cross the T's, so they have total clarity of what it's going to look like going forward.
Yeah, exactly. I think the one thing that, you know, and Bryan kind of opened this episode with this is people don't quite know what to expect when they come in. So once we've kind of figured out that we can be friends, we want to get along, we can trust each other, the next thing is kind of getting down to business, right? There's a reason that you are coming into our office or setting up a Zoom meeting. And I don't think it's because you have nothing better to do on a Tuesday or a Thursday, right? Like, there's a specific reason you're here. There's an issue, there's something you need our advice with, there's something you need help in solving. And so the first thing that we do is really just kind of mutually agree upon the purpose of the meeting. And for us, and we're a little bit different than a lot of other financial firms out there, the financial services industry sometimes gets a little bit of a tarnished reputation because so many financial professionals are always trying to sell you something, sell you a stock, a bond, a mutual fund, an ETF, whatever it is out there. And for us, the purpose of this meeting is just to get to know each other. It's to learn about your goals and objectives and the resources you've accumulated and the planning work that you've done thus far. And then the services and the resources that we provide to clients. And ultimately, if there's an alignment and we decide that it's a good fit, we'll agree upon what the next steps would be and move forward, as Jason mentioned earlier, through our holistic wealth management process into design and then deliver, which we'll get to in future episodes. But we go through the purpose. The next thing that we do is just identify if there's anything top of mind, anything on your agenda that you want to make sure we cover in this meeting. Maybe you've got a major issue that you need some immediate attention to, or maybe you just have a big concern on your mind, like you're getting ready to retire in the next 6 months and you're worried about the stock market and your portfolios and if they're allocated appropriately. Now, we want to get all of that on the table. We certainly might not have time to solve all of those issues in this meeting, but we want to get them documented. We want to get them on the table so that we could make sure that we address them, whether it's in the Discover meeting or as we go through the rest of the process. From there, we'll share our agenda. As Jason mentioned, we have a very specific process that we want to be able to make sure that we complete in this discovery meeting so that we have all the facts and all the details of what you have and what you've done and what's most important to you and where you want to be. And so we'll share that with you. Of course, we'll want to make sure that we have the agreed upon amount of time. If we say we're going to spend 60 minutes together or 90 minutes together, we want to make sure that we could account for being on time, respecting your time. And I'm sure we probably have other clients as well that are going to be coming in. And so, and then the last thing is just kind of the expected outcome. I mentioned earlier, the purpose of the meeting is to get to know each other. And so at the end of this Discover meeting, really one of two things happens. It's pretty simple. Either we mutually agree that there's a connection, that this is the right fit, that we can deliver what you're in need of, you see value in working with us, and we agree to move on to our second step, which is where we're going to start to design your plan, or we agree for whatever reason that it's just not a good fit right now. Maybe it's timing. Maybe you didn't like the tie I was wearing or the t-shirt. Maybe I didn't like something you did, right? Like, again, I'm kind of joking around here, but the reality of it is we're not a fit for everybody. We certainly understand that. And so we would agree upon that. But here's the one thing I will say with certainty. Even if we get to the end of that kind of outcome that, hey, it's not a fit at this time for whatever reason. The one thing I hear from clients over and over is that they've learned a lot along the way, and maybe they learned enough in that Discover meeting that they just don't really need to go through the rest of our services. Maybe they had a really simplistic problem that we could point them in the right direction on to get the advice or the information that they need. And it's not something that requires our help or our care or diligence. And so again, that's really just setting the big picture expectation and agenda of what's going to happen throughout the 60 to 90 minutes that we spend together in that Discover meeting.
That's a really good point, Dave. And Bryan, I want you to talk about kind of the consultation they have before Discovery just for in a moment here. But, you know, Dave, what went through my head as you talked about this is sometimes on that consultation, we can solve whatever their issue and point them in the right direction, which is typically a phone consultation before they come in for Discovery. But we can't be all things for all people, but we can be all things for some people. And that's why we're very selective on the new clients that we onboard to our firm. And that's why we want this Discovery process to happen and make sure that it's mutually going to be a great fit. But Bryan, do you mind talking a little bit about just that consultation and what that kind of looks like? Because a lot of times you come in here and they've shared on the consultation what they wanted to accomplish.
Yeah, so there's a precursor to this Discovery meeting. It's essentially where we get on a phone call for you. We call it a complimentary consultation. We offer it through everything we do, but it's just a 20-minute phone conversation. You get to talk with one of the experts in the firm, whether it's myself, Gary, or a few other individuals, and we just want to get an understanding of, like, how we can be of service to you and what are your needs. And as Jason said, sometimes it might be a very small need. Like, I had a client's son call in, and just had a quick question on, like, how much can I contribute to the IRA? I made this much money. What about a backdoor Roth? All that kind of stuff. And we were able to answer that on the phone. But what were we doing? We were being an advocate for our client. Now, another example, you're new to the firm and you want to go through this process. We just got to get an understanding of, like, hey, what do you have going on? What are your top concerns? What are your top priorities? What have you accumulated to solve some of your goals and make sure things are taken care of for the future? So we get an understanding of, are we the right fit for you? And can we continue this relationship into the future? And if everything makes sense, we have the ability to go into this Discovery phase. So there is a little bit of an upfront complimentary consultation where maybe we can address your immediate need right there. And you have some longer term aspirations. And that's where this Discovery phase comes in.
Yeah, I think what all of that does, guys, is, like, the most valuable asset we all have is not our money, it's our time. And so what we want to do throughout that complimentary consultation or this Discovery meeting is really be as efficient as we can with your time and our time. So if we do a complimentary consultation and we figure out you need to know how much you can put in your 401k this year, like, we can answer that really quickly on the spot and help you out if that's the only thing that you need. But when you want to engage in more holistic planning, right? Maybe you're having a much bigger decision, like you're about to retire, or you're about to have a liquidity event and sell your business, or you've just been granted a bunch of company stock. Those are the types of things where we'd probably say, hey, let's invest 60 minutes or 90 minutes together and really unpack that and dive deeper into what's going on in your situation.
Thanks for tuning in to the Bucket Plan On Demand, brought to you by C2P, an organization whose purpose is to educate, train, grow, and support holistic financial advisors so families can achieve true prosperity. Subscribe today for the latest episodes and insights. Visit C2PEnterprises.com to learn how we can help support and enhance your advisory business. At the time of delivery and any subsequent publishing, information was deemed reliable, but is subject to change by the time of listening or viewing. The contents of this piece include options and projections of C2P, are subject to change, and are for informational purposes only. The information provided in this presentation is not intended to be individual investment, tax, or legal advice.